Hello, friends. Welcome. Thank you for joining me. Today, I'm going to read a parable from my book, Parables from Turtle Island. Turtle Island is the name that the early people here in this continent called our land. These peoples had a custom where they told little stories to teach life lessons and history to their children. So I compiled a few of my own little stories of nature along with my daughter who joined the fun. Today, I hope that you enjoy the parable of the butterfly. There was a large tree with many branches that was covered with leaves. On one leaf, there were tiny eggs nestled in the center crevice of the leaf. One day, a small green worm emerged from one of the eggs. The little worm looked all around to see where she was, and she saw only a vast surface. So she inched her way to the top of an incline and looked down. Below was a chasm of endless space. The worm edged backward in fear and alarm. Then she began to look for others like herself. Being hungry, she ate the green food before her, and as she ate, she grew. When the food was gone, she looked to the right and left and found more food. She traveled in search of food, walking backward, never able to see where she was going, only where she had been. When the rain came, it replenished the green pasture, leaving pools of water to bathe and splash and groom herself in. However, soon the air began to be cold and the food became brown and dry. The worm began to spin a coat of black and white threads to keep out the cold. When the coat was finished, she wrapped herself tightly in it to keep out the chill of the bitter wind. She spent the long winter months in this home, in times of wakefulness and in times of dreams and sleep. At the end of winter, the coat began to feel too warm, and the little worm rolled it away and peeked out of her cocoon. She saw the green home that she had always known. Stepping out into the warm sun, she felt light as air. She ran and skipped, twirling about with joy. The spring rains had left pools of water, and as the little worm bent to drink, she looked at her reflection in the mirror surface. To her surprise, gone was the fat green body with the large black eyes and mouth. Looking back at her was a golden butterfly like the ones she'd seen in her dreams. She looked up and saw the shady trees above her and the bright sky around her. When she looked down, she saw flowers that beckoned her to come and delight in their fragrances. This had been here always, waiting for her, and she flew off happily into the sunshine. The end. I hope you enjoyed the story, and I hope you will come again and join me next time I read from my parables or my poetry. And in the meantime, look around you and enjoy a wonderful day. Shalom.